I shall raise up for David a righteous branch, and he will reign as king and act wisely and do justice and righteousness in the land. And this is his name by which he will be called, the Lord our righteousness. God didn't need help to bring his plan for our salvation to pass. Just as he had spoken stars into existence, Jesus could have simply appeared. But 1 Corinthians explains that God chose the foolish things of the world to shame the wise, and he chose the weak things of the world to shame the strong. So in his wisdom, God chose a humble little Jewish girl to bring about the greatest miracle the world had ever known. Emmanuel would be knit together within her womb. The Creator would be created in human flesh and born as a baby. And as it always is with God's plans, he would do all the wonders it would take to make it happen if she would simply say, "Yes, Lord, I'm willing."
Yeah.
Joseph was a good man. The news that Mary was going to have a baby turned his world upside down. Then came the dream. Joseph, don't be afraid. He must have repeated those words to himself over and over in the weeks and months that followed. What can we say about the night Jesus came that hasn't been said a million times? We retrace every step of the journey from Nazareth to Bethlehem. We picture Joseph's frantic search for a place for Jesus to be born. We try to imagine that first cry, but in the end, we're left without adequate words to describe this night of nights. first visitors who came to pay honor to the baby king were a bunch of slightly confused, still frightened shepherds. After being confronted with a sky full of angels, they wasted no time in finding Jesus. And when they did, it was clear that this baby was unlike any who had ever been born. The message of the angels was glory to God and peace to earth. Jesus accomplished both of these with his birth. His coming in love and obedience brought honor to his Father. His presence meant peace was possible. God was with us in a way he had never been.
Oh,
that holy night when Jesus was born, angels sang praises and shepherds worshiped. Before long, wealthy kings also found themselves at his feet. Ever since then, this is the choice God presents us with. Will we remain unaware of the Savior's arrival or be unimpressed with his coming?